the Thistle Grub Elementals out in Tanaris are an extremely, extremely recommended mob to do on this series. And, you know, we've taken about a week break, so I figured we gotta come back and start the series off with a bang. And while these guys don't have the most crazy loot table, we are gonna be getting things, you know, our Fade Leafs, our Swift Thistles, maybe a couple Bruise Weeds, or if we're lucky, maybe greater mana potions or some superior healing potions. All those items I just listed are between a 1 and 4% drop rate off these guys, so while they don't have, you know, the craziest loot that they drop, you know, one sick item, the Eye of Divinity or whatever, they do have a pretty steady source of herbs. So a lot of people have been asking me to kill these guys just because, well, they're curious about what herbs they can get, and maybe this is an alternative to herbalism for this level range. So without further ado, we got our Chromatic Sword, we got our first May Hat, and let's get right back into 500 total kills. So let's go ahead and reset our kill tracker, and I think we are good to go. Feels good to be back, man. Thank you guys for sticking around. I hope you guys had a good New Year's and holiday time, you know. I bought myself a VR headset to celebrate, but for our first kill, we get 1 silver, 45 copper. All right, so it's not looking good on the first kill. It's always a little demoralizing to not get anything cool on the first kill, but that's okay. We're going to stick to it. Somehow I managed to get the Onyxia buff for this. So for the first 2 hours of this farm, I don't think we're going to have any problem at all. I'm not going to rock the Chromatic Sword all day today on this farm just because they are high level 40s. And I do want to get this done and have this video out relatively soon. So I took a little break from the videos, guys, and I've been playing a lot of Escape from Tarkov. And I played a lot of Cyberpunk until the bugs just kind of got a little out of hand for me on Cyberpunk. But I really enjoyed playing it. So that's what I was doing with my week off. First herb of the day, our Fire Balloon. Love to see it. Also, my add-ons got a little weird, so I'm going to have to use the normal bag just for this video. So I guess technically speaking, on my server, the best flowers these guys could drop would be the Swift Thistle. And if you guys saw my elemental farming video out in Ashenvale, you'll know that I have not had the best luck when it comes to Swift Thistle. I'll leave the link to that video at the end of this one, because I think it's pretty funny, but for now, Briarthorn, love to see it. Buy more silver. And a raw black truffle. I gotta be sure not to eat these truffles by accident. What is rooting me? Oh, these little earth crab totems. Very cool. Another fun fact about these guys is this is where you have to do the quest to get your Noggin Fogger elixir, which I should have bought for the sake of the video. Silly me, but it's the elixir, you know, that turns you into a skeleton or makes you really small or what's the third one? Oh, it gives you slow fall effect. So you have to come out here and get a dew gland for the goblin over at Tanaris. But we got an empty dew gland there. Pretty cool. These guys are just dropping like butter, man. A lot of people say, you know, phase 6 isn't their favorite part of the game. But I'll be honest, it's kind of fun to run around with super OP items and stuff. Even though this character doesn't have any Nax items. I'm also leveling a Warlock now, guys. And I'm just, you know, casually doing quests and stuff. If you guys want me to stream that or something, let me know in the comments. But I don't know if people would really be interested in that type of stuff. But let me know. Right now I have a 60 Rogue, Warrior, Mage, Priest, and a Druid. So I'm working on the Warlock right now. The reason I'm working on all those classes too is, you know, I'm only going to play my Warrior in TBC. But I want to have all those classes at 70 just so I know how to beat them. You know, like I'm really, really afraid of Warlocks come, you know, 70 arenas. I'm really afraid of them. So if I have a 70 Warlock and I know how to play it, it'll kind of help me beat them from the inside. Respawns are sick. No competition because it's a very unorthodox farm. So, and honestly, guys, if the videos, I mean, I'm having to get creative with these farms. I've done the Crusaders. I've done the Frostmaw Echoes. You know what I mean? I'm really, ooh, a Sungrass, those are worth a lot. I'm really having to get creative, so if you see the video ideas getting a little weird, just know that, you know, I'm really struggling to come up with ideas. So if anybody watching this, you know, you have any ideas, dude, for any mobs at all, let me know in the comments, because I really love the ideas. I really love it's so nice to, you know, just have an idea to go off. Grom's Blood used to be so much, dude. On Nostarius, that's how I bought my first epic mount ever on Classic, like 4 years ago, bro. Just picking Grom's Blood and Fellwood. If you guys don't know, Grom's Blood is used for things like the Flask of the Titan or the Elixir of Brute Force. So Grom's blood is really good. It's just surprising to me that it's rather cheap. Alright, whoa, look at that. Instant respawn right on top. We are at 99 kills. This flew by way quicker than I thought. I actually kind of lost track. It only took half an hour to get 30 kills, so we should be out of here in like two and a half hours at this rate. Which is great, because I have a dentist appointment today. So, anyway, we haven't gotten anything crazy though. I actually don't think we've gotten a single green other than this distress beacon. So, if you ask me, that's pretty weird. But, maybe we're just saving all our luck and gonna cash it in for a sweet purple. So, hopefully that's the case. But either way, for our 100th Thistle Grub Elemental today, we get 2 silver, 32 copper. Alright, nothing too crazy yet, but I'll be honest, it feels really good to be back, man. So, let's turn up the tunes, and I will talk to you guys at 499 total kills.
Oh shit, here we go again.
Guess who just got back today? Them wild-eyed boys that had been away. Haven't changed, had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are great. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. I told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. I said, the boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. Chick that used to dance a lot. Every night she'd be on the floor shaking what she'd got. Man, when I tell you she was cool, she was red hot. I mean she was steaming. And that time over at Johnny's place, well, this chick got up and she slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell about the place. If that chick don't wanna know, forget her.
Alright, bro, here we are at 499 total kills, and man, does it feel good to be back. for this spot, I had obviously like no problems at all. Not too many people are out here farming. There's the occasional lobby doing their quest, and then you would get a 60 coming out here trying to kill these dew collectors. So I did end up kind of leaving a couple dew collectors just because I want people to be able to actually finish this quest. It's a huge pain for the Noggin Fogger Elixir, but regardless, we made it. 499 kills in. Let's go find our 500th Thistle Grub Elemental and be out of here. I'm not going to lie, though, guys. I'm actually really digging Tanaris. I might do the Dune Maul Ogres tomorrow. But if you guys have any ideas for mobs, let me know, because I don't know. I'm really digging Tanaris. But either way, 500th kill. We got a Thistle Grub Dew Collector. We got our Recklessness. No Death Wish today, though, but that's all right. Because for our 500th Thistle Grub Elemental today, we get 4 silver, 40 copper, and 1 punctured dew gland. Alright, not too much interesting loot, I'll be honest, but definitely some cool herbs and stuff to go over, so I'm gonna move all the loot, and I will catch you guys in Stormwind. Alright guys, so here we are in Stormwind, and thankfully I got my bag add-on working for this character, but before we get into the loot, let's look at the kills here. 188 of the dew collectors, 157 of the root shapers, and 155 of the gnarled thistle shrub. So good variety of 3 mobs there, nothing too crazy. I thought I killed less dew collectors because I really was avoiding them to try to like let other people get them so they could finish their quest, but yeah, whatever. But getting into my favorite part of all the videos, as usual, the loot, guys. So real quick, getting it out of the way, only 2 greens today, bro. That's absolutely insane to me. But only 2 greens, the Griffin Mail, Crown of the Monkey, and then this Formula Enchant Weapon Demon Slaying. This thing is actually super rare, but it's too bad it's not worth that much. But with that out of the way, We got 1 Ghost Mushroom, 2 Life Root, 3 Briar Thorn, 4 Fire Bloom, 1 Purple Lotus, 2 Grom's Blood, 4 Arthas Tears, 2 Fade Leaf, 2 Strangle Kelp, 1 Silver Leaf, 2 Khadgar's Whisker, 1 Earth Root, 4 Swift Thistle, 1 Bruise Weed, 5 Winter's Bright, 5 Police Bloom, 34 Heart of the Wilds, 1 Scroll of Strength, 3 Scrolls of Intellect, as well as 8 Greater Mana Potions, and 12 Superior Healing Potions. Always more Superior Healing Pots than Mana Pots from these farms, I found out. Alright, and being that those guys were elementals, we are sitting at 16 gold, 61 silver. Not too bad at all from those guys. I mean, they're high level 40, so that's expected. But when we vendor up all these nice grays, we get up to a 25 gold, 95 silver. So about a fourth of your normal amount there, if you still haven't managed to get it somehow by 50, I guess. So not terrible, but definitely not great. Alright, so I don't know where to start on these auctionals, bro. I'll be honest, but I guess we'll just do the greens first up. Demon Slaying. We haven't seen one of these being sold since November 12th. I know this is crazy, but I'm going to do 40 gold on this. If it hasn't been seen in over a month, that might not be too ridiculous there, honestly. Griffin Mail Crown of the Monkey. Monkey always sells good. Stamina, agility, hunters love it. Greater Mana Pot. Superior Healing Pot. 10 silver each on those. That's kind of low, to be honest. The healing pots and the mana pots are sitting at 10 silver. It's kind of odd. 1 Earth Root, 2 silver there. 4 Swift Thistle, 4 gold for that. 1 Ghost Mushroom, 35 silver. 2 Life Root, 40 silver. Winter's Bite, 1 gold. Bruise Weed, 30 silver. Fire Bloom, 4 Fire Bloom for 4 gold. 3 Briar Thorn for 30 silver. Peace Bloom, the best flower in the entire game, 32 silver for 5. We got our Hearts of the Wild. They're at 13 silver each right now. We got 3 stacks of those. Not too great there. Khadgar's Whisker. 2 Stranglethelp for 72 silver. 2 Grom's Blood for 15 silver. Grom's Blood cheaper than Stranglekelp. That's crazy. 1 Purple Lotus, 50 silver. Silver Leaf, 5 silver. Arthas Tears, 1 silver apiece. And Fade Leaf, 77 silver apiece. This is used for rogues for their Thistle Tea. Or for their blinding powder, actually. It's for their blinding powder. So, Fade Leaf always sells really well. Scroll of Strength. And 3 Scrolls of Intellect. Guys, it feels really good to be back. I really enjoyed doing this farm. Super cozy, super chill. I think for, you know, these next few videos, I'm going to have to get a little creative with these spots. So they're going to be a little unorthodox. And, well, they might be a little bit weird, but if you have any ideas for mobs or spots, let me know in the comments. Now's the time, bro. I'm really going to have to, you know, reach and get creative here. So if you have any ideas, any recommendations for the series at all, please let me know in the comments below. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And I have a lot of fun doing this. And I wouldn't be able to do it without you guys watching. So thank each and every one of you for watching. I really do appreciate it. But I'll leave my Twitch up on screen now as well, guys. I have been streaming over there a little bit. Played a little Cyberpunk. It's pretty fun. So if you got the time, go leave me a follow over there. I'm going to stream all day, every day when TBC gets released. So if you're into that kind of stuff, head on over there. But I'm starting to ramble, guys. If you need a nice chill farm with tons of different flowers, hit up those Thistle Dew elementals. But just know it really isn't the craziest gold per hour. But either way, that's going to do it for this video, guys. Be sure to like and sub if you haven't, if you want more of these daily, you know, goofy WoW videos. But that's all for me, guys. So thank you so much for watching. Take care. My name is Barak H. Have a good one, and I will see you guys in the next one.